down here at the Midwest Airgun Show. I'm Chad Kettner with American Airgunner, and we have Larry Hannusch here, all the way from Texas?
Houston, Texas.
Houston, Texas, he made the trip. Did you drive?
Of course.
And how many hours?
22 straight.
22 hours straight. And this is not your first time here. You always come, it seems like. And he brings the coolest air guns. And we got one right here. This is a ball reservoir out of your personal collection.
That's correct, yes.
Can you tell us just a little bit about this? Because
yes,
most people back home have never seen anything like it.
Okay, this is unusual in a couple ways because most guns of this sort were European, British or European. This happens to be an American ball reservoir gun. And it's unmarked, beautiful condition, tap loader, about 35, 36 caliber tap loader.
35 caliber, okay.
This is filled up, the ball is taken off, filled with a hand pump, and that'll give you enough air pressure at about 500-600 PSI to get a half a dozen shots.
So I want to stop you there for a second, because we were just talking about the Gerardoni down there earlier on another video, and that's 850 PSI.
Right.
This is a 35 cal with 500 some PSI.
500, 600, depending on the pump and how heavy you are, because they're hand pump.
Very good.
If you're a big, large guy, you're going to get higher pressure.
But for me, what everyone wants is like a 4,500 PSI air reservoir.
Yeah.
To shoot a 35 caliber pellet.
Yeah.
You don't need that,
you don't
guys.
Need it.
You don't need that. This is only 500 PSI. All right.
Volume. We're pushing volume. That's what it is.
Volume. Okay.
Volume. Okay. This, once the thing is filled with air, the hammer's cocked back. Now it's set. This is a direct strike type. So when the hammer flies forward, I'm going to release it slowly. It pushes down on a valve. The valve is inside the ball. The check valve and the exhaust valve are one and the same.
That's all right. So let me just follow this up. Let's put this up here. So this hammer is going to come down and hit the valve that's at the top of this air cylinder.
You want to see the striker? Let me just show you a little closer.
You guys want to see the striker back home, don't you?
Yeah, I know I do. Of course. So don't drop it and break a toe. There's your striker.
Okay.
This is just like a firing pin, basically. It's driven by a big spring, and it strikes down here. That little pin comes down.
Can I hold that for a second for you?
Absolutely. Showing the camera, you can see.
It's like a cannonball.
Yeah, big everything.
I don't know if you can see down there. There is a valve in there with the pin.
Right.
And that hammer comes down and pushes that pin down, which releases a puff of air.
That's great.
A big puff of air.
Big puff. Yeah, maybe half a dozen of them.
And
the hand pump is screwed onto here and just hand pumped.
Okay.
All this was hand pumped. The cool thing about this gun is it came a pair of them a few years ago showed up, and it said they were from the New York area. American-made antique air guns, pneumatic air guns, are very, very rare, quite expensive, so it's cool, but no way to verify. So
we don't know
no markings,
who the maker was.
But.
And that's kind of the cool thing about air guns. I mean, there's a rich history.
There is.
In air guns.
Absolutely. Well, we got talking, knowing the guy who did the shoebox compressors. His name was Tom Kay. And he has a fascinating hobby also of being a sleuth, amateur scientist. He has electron microscopes in his house, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
He said, I'll tell you what, let's take this out. We took the valve out, took scrapings of the grease that stuck inside there. He took it on his electron microscope and analyzed it. And he has a huge database. Came back and said the cells on this thing were from a pollen that's known from a certain variety of plant that comes from upper New York, lower Canada.
That adds
a lot of verification to the probability this truly did come from New York.
So you guys back home are into air guns. You're not scraping the grease out of your air reservoirs, I don't think. But there are air gunners out here like Larry who are doing the history, who know the history of where we started with these things, going back to Lewis and Clark and beforehand. And this is just a prime example of where we're starting in America with these air guns and these ball reservoirs. Now, I got one more here I want to share with you. And I'm hopefully you can tell me just a little bit more about this one. Because this reminds me very much of a Gerardoni.
All right.
Is it?
Exactly. Same designs. An Austrian gun. Reservoir here. Same way. Like you were looking at the other one over here. It's a reservoir. You see, it's been extremely rusty, exceedingly rusty. It's really rough, been refinished. But the interesting thing about this, you notice that this, the brass, the lock case is engraved. Not too bad a shape, you can see engraving on it. But this is pitted. This was found by some hunters in the 1950s up in Vermont. They were hunting.
Okay.
And they found this stuck in the ground.
How would you like to do that? Find that stuck in the ground.
Down the ground. So this is what it was. This is how rusted up, and it's came to me through a variety of contacts about maybe 25, 30 years, probably 25 years ago. And I end up with a gun, but this was found, and that's why it's so rough. It's just a cool piece because
it's a history, right?
History. Somebody lost this thing, say, you know, maybe a couple hundred years ago, because it dates from, you know, early 1800s.
And if you look here, you can actually still see this is riveted, and these are rivets, right?
Mm-hmm, exactly.
And what is really cool, I mean, I was wondering, I've walked past this probably three or four times already today, what the texture was, but that's straight up rust.
That's an iron that rusted because it's buried in the ground for so many years.
It got a little hole right here.
Yeah, yeah, you can't put air in that one. You can't, but it's going to come right back out.
Come right back out. Now, traditionally, how much pressure in something like a rust?
That's the same we're talking about. Probably in the, up to 800 PSI, probably.
Up to 800 PSI. And this is what caliber?
That one there is 45-ish.
45-ish. And they would actually use these for hunting?
Absolutely.
So, as the hunting...
I've used it for hunting for years.
Have you really?
Not this one, but...
Others?
For decades.
Hunting with air guns, big game, larger game, it's not a new thing.
No.
And we talk about it on the forums like it is. Like, oh, It's not new, guys. This has been going on for hundreds and hundreds of years. And people like Larry are keeping that tradition, those histories, alive for us today. So, Larry, man, thanks for doing all that work.
Absolutely.
It's awesome having you come to the show and bring stuff like this.
Appreciate y'all doing the show. It's been a great show. I've enjoyed it. Good group of guys, good facility. Need to join you next year. It's
absolutely.
Great place.
If he can drive 22 hours from Texas, you guys can drive three or 4 hours and get here.
Yeah, come on, really.
Absolutely. Exactly. So, hey, until next time, guys, get out there, shoot your air guns, look up some history, start collecting some of this older stuff because it's absolutely magnificent. And we'll see you next time right here on American Air Gunner.